Good morning, everyone. Today we will discuss one more very important network theorem, maximum power transfer theorem. Maximum power transfer theorem. This theorem states that the source will transfer maximum power to the load. Then source resistance is equal to load resistance. So this theorem is called maximum power transfer theorem. Okay, so as the title indicates, the theorem is deals with the transfer of power from the source to the load. Okay, and what it tells? It tells that the source will transfer maximum power to the load when source resistance is equal to load resistance. Okay, so before going into the details of the theorem, we will first see that what is source resistance and what is load resistance. So let us take a EMF source of EMF E. It has its inherent resistance. Any source, EMF source, it may be a DC source or it may be AC source. It is always associated with some inherent or internal resistance. Okay, and it appears always in series with the source, called as the source resistance or internal resistance of the source. Okay, now let us connect a load across this source. Now what is so load? Load may be anything. It may be a device, it may be any instrument, it may be any appliance, or simply a resistance which drives a current from the source. Okay, so let's say RL is the resistance offered by the load. Okay, and suppose it is driving a current I from the source. Okay, then from the circuit we can write I is equal to E by RS plus RL. Simple Ohm's law. You can see in the circuit, it's RS and RL are in series. Okay, so the resultant is RS plus RL. Okay, so the battery or source E, so voltage divided by resistance is current. Okay, this is equation number one. Now PL, power delivered to the load by the source. So it is equal to I into VL, product of current flowing through the load and the potential drop across the load. Since electric power is the product of the electric current and the voltage. Okay, so in this case, I is the current, okay, and VL, voltage across the load, it will be I into RL. Okay, VL is I into RL. Since I is the current flowing through RL, so voltage drop will be I into RL. So it is equal to I square RL. Now what is PL? From equation 1, I will be E by RS plus RL. Okay, and as there is square, so the square of this into R. We rewrite this as E square into RL divided by RS plus RL whole square. let's assume that the EMF of the source and source resistance RS are fixed. So PL will be function of RL. That means PL is only dependent on RL. Okay, now we have to prove this theorem. And to prove this theorem, we have to find out the condition for which the source will transfer maximum power to the load. Okay, and for this we use the concept of mathematics. So what is the concept? Let's say y is equal to f of x is an equation which represents a curve in xy plane. Like this. Let us draw a tangent to this curve at this point, at the maxima. So you can see the tangent to the curve at the maxima is horizontal line. That means its slope is zero. What is the slope of the tangent? It is given by dy by dx. Okay, and at maxima, it is zero. Okay, dy by dx is the slope of the tangent to the curve, and at maximum, this tangent is horizontal line. That means its slope is zero. The same logic we are using for the maximum power delivered to the load by the source. Okay, so what we are now going to do? We calculate dPL by dRL. Okay, then we equate it to zero like this. Then we will get the condition for which the source will transfer maximum power to the load. Okay, so capture this dPL by dRL. So this PL is E square, it's constant, therefore we write it before, okay, and then derivative of the square bracket RL divided by RS plus RL square. Now use a quotient rule to obtain the derivative of the square bracket. dPL by dRL equal to E square and the quotient rule. So what is the quotient rule? Denominator as it is, that is RS plus RL whole square as it is, into derivative of the numerator, that is derivative of RL with respect to RL, so it is 1. Then minus derivative of denominator, that is derivative of the RS plus RL whole square, it is 2 times RS plus RL into numerator as it is, that is RL as it is. Okay, and this is divided by the square of the denominator, that means square of the RS plus RL square, that means raised to power 4. Okay, and as for the condition, the maxima, we are equating this to 0, therefore we will write 0 is equal to E square in bracket RS plus RL whole square minus 2 times RS plus RL into RL divided by RS plus RL raised to 4. Okay, now since this product E square cannot be 0, okay, therefore this bracket must be equal to 0. Again, the denominator cannot be equal to 0 since RS and RL, they are 0. Therefore, this numerator must be equal to 0. Okay, that means RS plus RL whole square minus 2 times RS plus RL into RL is equal to 0. Okay, now if you transfer this term into right, so it will give RS plus RL whole square is equal to 2 times RS plus RL into R. Okay, now we can cancel one of the term RS plus RL from the square with this term on right. Okay, so on left there remain RS plus RL and on right there remain 2 into R. Okay, so this will comes out to be RS is equal to R. Okay, and this is what the maximum power transfer theorem is. Okay, same thing we have made here, but we have stated it here. Okay, the theorem was the source will transfer maximum power to the load when source resistance is equal to load resistance. RS is the source resistance, RL is load resistance, and this is we get when we equate this dPL by dRL, the first order derivative of PL with respect to RL to 0, okay, which will give us the condition for maxima of PL at certain value of RL. That value of RL is RS.